So let me now go to the other one. So let me now show you this. I think the screen is being presented.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I think it's clear enough. So now let me take you directly to launch the simulator. I have already sent a friend request to you all, for the entire students of this batch. So all of you, please, did you all receive the mail? To join this circuit sim platform. So what I expect you to do is, please accept it, login with your login device, login ID, and you will be able to construct these circuits and take the screenshot, or you can download the image. That is what I have been telling you. I think that would be better for you also. Okay, so now let me show you how to do. See, this is my ID, this is my dashboard. Likewise, you also can calculate. See, these are all the circuits. I will show you one after the other now. The circuits are seen, and my groups are, I have seen some 8 of you having joined. Yeah, 8 members have joined. All others who can join, I'll show you who are all the ones who have joined. Initially is what I've given. Slowly people are joining, I think. Mohita, Sushma, 37, Shruti, Akhila, Udaya and Pavani. Roll number 11, Varshita, Vaishnavi. These are the people who have joined. So others, if you can join, you will be able to do this better. Okay, let me now show you my circuit. I think you are able to see my screen. 1 second. So now what all you require, now let us do, we are doing full adder. So first input, full adder requires 3 inputs, so bring that here. One input, A, this is the second input, this is your third input. Inputs are required, and you require for this requires 2 half adders. You can just check your notes. By the way, I've shared my OneNote notes to your Google Classroom. What you have to do is, all of you have your MS Office. I think MS Office you have to load into your mobile phones. If you don't have already, download that and open with OneNote. You will be able to see the entire class notes. Whatever I am doing on the digital slate, you will be able to see that. So the circuit is, it requires 2 half adders. So for each half adder output, what you need is 2 LEDs, one for the carry, the other one for sum. So two LEDs are required. Then each half adder requires two gates. What are the two gates it requires? An AND gate and an exclusive OR gate. So you need one more AND gate for the other half adder. So get one more here, one more exclusive OR gate. Okay. Enough, these circuits are enough for us. So now what to do is, so now take it little away so that you'll be able to see the circuit better. Take it up. So first AND gate and first exclusive OR gate are required. They are required for what? For the first half adder. First draw these lines and keep it ready everywhere and drag it. I think you all know because you are all used to multisim. Draw, how neatly you draw your circuit, accordingly you draw them here also. Give enough space between the elements. This you need. Inputs. So now this, let us join these two. This is your B, this is your A. These two are your A. Okay, one is A, one is B. Okay. Then similarly you have to draw these two circuits here. Okay. So now what is it that we have to say? This is your carry. Let me write it here. So for writing something, what you need to do? Go to miscellaneous. Go to miscellaneous. Go to text box. Go to text box. Okay. Where, what will you write here? CY. CY is actually carry, but when I write CI, it's carry. So this top one is carry. Then the other one is sum. So bring, okay, this is taken it as sum. So this is sum. Again go to text. You cannot overwrite on that, so you have to take one more text box and write carry. So that carry is here. Then we copy. There is a copy. Copy, control V. So this is carried here. And this is again copy, control V. So this is, so for the first half adder this is carry, this is sum. For the second one this is carry and this is sum. Okay, now what should you do? This sum, where is the sum? This sum is, now this is, these are A and B. So now what have you to do is, this is your C. C is your third input. The third input has to be connected to this. If you want, you can this. So you can, if you want, you can label this as A, this is your B, this is your C. So the last one I will write, the last one, C in. We call it as C in. That is this input. These two, if you want, you can name it as A and B. So once again go to text and okay, bring the text here, and inside this is one way of writing it. You can write A, then bring the text box here, and inside this you write B. So you have A, B and C. Okay, now what should you do? Now how do you connect these to this? So A, these to 0 plus 1 is added. If there is a carry, there is no carry. The sum is 1. So that sum has to be joined to this input. There is no carry. So what are we doing? This carry, this carry, and this carry are joined by means of another OR gate. So you need another gate. What gate do you need? You need OR gate. Where is OR gate? This is OR gate. If you just hold it here, you will be able to see what it means. Bring that here. Okay. Bring the OR gate here. See, what are you doing? Both the carries are joined together. Why both carries are joined together? I'll tell you. 0 plus 1 is what you have done. And 0 plus 1 will give you what? 0 plus 1 is 1. So sum is 1, carry is 0. Now this 1, supposing this is also 1, this 1 and 1 will give you sum as 0, carry as 1. So this carry and this carry get added up. Therefore, you have a final carry here. This is your final carry. Final carry is connected to this LED. Now, this sum is connected here. This is your another carry. So, this is the last input. What should happen to this sum? See, 1 plus 1, 2 plus 3 plus 5, suppose you are adding. 2 plus, let us say 2 plus 9. 2 plus 9 is 11. So that 1 is carry. This 1 plus 5. So this has to be added here. And this is your final sum. This final sum is connected to this LED. There is no connection, as you can see. Join it. You join these two. Already it is taken. Now let us understand each of them. Let us give them all zeros first. You have given them all zeros. So therefore, 0 plus 0 plus 0 is 0. So what do you have? This is 0. This is also 0. Okay. So you'll have to take 8 screenshots. Take the screenshot of this. Then, let us say A is your least significant bit. So 0 plus 1 is somewhere, some connection is lost. Let us see. This is the connection that is lost. Out anywhere, anything. So this is A. A are connected. This is B. This is B. Maybe. This is B. This is B. So B and B anywhere, just check if the connection is lost anywhere, you won't get it properly. Maybe this is not connected. So 0, 0, 0, all are 0. So let's make this as 1. Okay, so this sum is going here. This is one input. The other input is, one input is coming from here. This input is, okay, so correct only, 001. Let me just connect it once again. If it doesn't connect also, there is a problem. Okay. So now, this is your carry, this is your sum. So this sum and this sum are connected. So this will have carry, this will have sum. So what happens, directly this input is connected here. This way. Draw this line and keep it. So this directly is connected here. This is directly connected here. Now how do you connect these two? So now this is directly going here. This is your carry. This is your sum. So the sum is going here, and this C is same as this C. It's not getting connected, I think. This is an OR gate and XOR, XOR, XOR. Okay. So 0 plus 1, sum should be 1. This is 1, 1 plus 0 should be 1. Okay. So now this is not getting connected. See, if there is no connection problem, then only it won't come. So 0 plus 1, it is 1. Next, 0, 0, 0, 0, now 0, 0, 0, 1. Now next is 0, 1, 0. Let us go in a sequence. 0, 1, 0, that is 0, 1. See, 3 inputs are there, you will get 8 possibilities. 0, 1, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. So, sum is 1, carry is 0. Next, 0, 1, 0, then 0, 1, 1. What is 0, 1, 1? 0, 1, 1, 1, 1 is, sum is 0, carry is 1. Since this is 0, this is also 0, the carry output is 0. Then, 0, 1, 1. Then, this is 0, this is 0. This is 1. 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0, what is happening? 0 plus 0, sum is 0, carry is 0. So these two inputs are 0. You get 1 only here, and this is 0 already. 0 plus 1, sum is 1, carry is 1. Next, each of these identities, whatever you are getting, each of these possibilities, you must take the screenshots, okay? And then all these screenshots, you paste it into your Word file. You will get 8. So maybe if not one page, you try pasting it in 2 pages. 4 possibilities in each. Okay. Then 101. What is 101? See, 0 to 7. No, 3 possibilities. 000, 001, 010, 011, 101 like that. 111. All possibilities. Now this is 1 plus 0. What is 1 plus 0? Sum is 0. 1 plus 0. Let us just try this first. 1 plus 0. Sum is 1. Carry is 0. But this is 1. Carry. This carry is 0. Now this is 1. Now 1 plus 1. This is 1. 1 plus 1 is? What is 1 plus 1? Sum is 0. Carry is 1. So this carry was 0. But this carry is 1. 0 plus 1. What is happening? What are you getting? 0 plus 1. This is an OR gate. If one of the inputs is high, the output is going to be high. Right? This is 101. 101 is 5. Then 110. 110. 110. Once again, what is 110? 0 plus 1 is 1. So carry is 1. Sum is 0. Sum is 0. 0 plus 1. What have I given? 1, 1 and 0. 1, 1 and 0. So 0 plus 1 carries 0 plus 1. Sum is 1. But this is 1. Okay. There is a problem here. 0 plus 1 when you do, you expect sum to be 1. Right? And carry is 0. No doubt about it. But this sum 1 here will get added to this another carry bit here. Thereby 1 plus 1 will become sum 0. Final carry is 1. If you want to see what is happening in between, you connect 2 more LEDs at different stages. connect one LED here. You connect one LED here. Similarly, you can connect one LED here. Any number of LEDs. It's not a lab, so you can take any number. Anyway, this is final carry. So now let us see. What have you given? 0, 1, 1. Did you make any mistake? No. So 0, 1 plus 1. 1, 1, 0. This is one carry. This is another carry. Okay. Fine. So 1, 1, 0. Okay. 1, 1, 1. All ones. All ones. What's happening? This is giving a problem. Insert anything. We will remove this. Yeah, everywhere the connection, only you have to make sure that the connection is properly made. So 1, 1, 1. What is 1, 1, 1? 1 plus 1 is 1 plus 1. Carry is 1, right? And sum is 0. Now 0 plus 1, sum should be 1. Carry is 0. So both should be 1 at this stage. Somewhere a connection problem. Let's check. This is A. This is A. These two are B. So A, B are 1. Maybe we'll remove this. It's interfering. It's interfering. Let's see. So all ones, 1 plus 1, 0. Okay. Now go to tools. Go to combinational analysis. What are the inputs you are giving? A, comma, B, comma, C, N. And what is the output? Output is sum and carry. I'll just write CY. Can you see this is generated, right? Adjust your circuit and this in such a way that you will be able to see everything together. You are able to see the circuit as well as the truth table now. So now reduce the size of this. I'm not able to reduce beyond. Okay, this much only I can do. I think you are able to see. So 0, 0, 0, 0 plus 0 plus 0. What is sum? 0. What is carry? 0. And see whether it happens here. Yeah, sum is 0. Yes. Now 0, 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0, 1. So A, B. A is, let us say, 1. Put it this way. I may 001. So my A B, actually A B 000. Let's make this as 1. Okay. So that means my A is made 1. Oh, this okay, understand it this way. Or maybe we can do combinational analysis. Let's write C in first. C in comma B comma A. Because this is how we are doing. Let us put it this way. And this is your Q. So when you have this like this, next, created now. So all zeros, it was 0. Now when it is 001, you can see the circuit. Accordingly, you can write here. What was Q? Q, no, no, okay. C in comma B comma A. Here I want to write first sum. So sum comma carry. If you want, you can write it this way. So 0, 0, 0. Sum is 0, carry is 0. Now what did you give? 001. You should be able to see the circuit as well as the truth table. So 001, what is happening? This 2 will give you what? This 2 will give you 1 here. Okay? And this 1 and this is 0. So 1 plus 0, sum is 1. Okay? And this is 0, this is 0, carry. So sum is 1. Sum is 1, carry is 0. Next, 0, 1, 0. So this is 0. This is 1. 0, 1, 0. 0 plus 1, 1. Sum is 1. So therefore, sum is again 1. And this is 0. Right? Then next is 0, 1, 1. 0, this is 1, this is 1. And now what's happening? 1 plus 1. Sum is 0. Carry is 1. Okay? This is 0. This also is 0. Definitely this is 0. But carry is 0. But this carry is high. This being an OR gate, one of the inputs is high, the output is high. So what will you write here? Sum is 0, but carry is 1. Next, 0, 1, 1 is over. Next, 1, 0, 0. So this is 0, this is 0, this is 1. So 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0 plus 0, both carry and sum are zeros. But this is 1, so 0 plus 1 is 1. So sum is 1, carry is still 0. So sum is 1. And carry is 0. Fine. Next you have 101. 101. 101, what's happening? 1 plus 0 is sum 1, carry is 0. This 1 and 1, this 1 get added. Then what will you get? Something happened. What did I give? What should I give? 101. 101. One zero zero, fine. Okay. 100, what are you getting? Sum as 1 and carry is 0. This is your final carry. Okay, next what are you applying? 101. C is 1. This is 0. This is 1. What's happening? 1 plus 0 should be sum 1. Sum 1. Okay. This is 0. 1 and this is 1. So then 1 plus 1, sum should be 0, carry should be high. What is happening? 101, carry should be high. Somewhere connection is gone, just check. Some problem I think. Okay. Now connect it. So 1 plus 0, 1 plus 0, sum is 1, 1 plus 1, sum is 0, carry should be 1. 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, let us try 1, 1, 0. 1, 1, 0. 1, 1, 0, what's happening? 1, see two inputs, sum is 0. Here it's only 1, so sum is 1, carry should be 0. Next 1, 0, 1, sum should be 0. 1 plus 1, sum should be 0. 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. 2, even number of inputs, so the output sum definitely is 0. Carry should be 1. Why carry is not 1? Carry is 1 now. You can see it's glowing. Some connection problem. Okay, next, so that means 1, 0, 1. 101 carry is 1. Next, what should you give? 110. 110. 110 even. So sum is 0. Carry should be 1. Maybe I'll connect it again. So that means sum is 0, carry is 1. Next, all ones. All ones. All ones, it's coming correctly only, I think. All ones. All are ones. So sum is 1 and carry is 101 only is giving a problem. Both are ones. 110, what is the problem? Let's see. 110. We'll check it. It's coming. So, generate the circuit. You can, if you want, you can now project, save online. If you save it online, it will get saved into your save as, it will come. Or you can say save offline. If you save offline, it will tell you where it has to be saved. Choose the file and save it. Is it clear? Can I proceed? Have you all followed this? 101 only is giving a problem. 110. 110. This carry and this carry. Maybe the bulb is not connected. Okay, you just try out, girls. This will come like this. So this is about adders. We finished about half adder and full adder. Okay. Next, what you have is in your circuits, NAND and NOR as universal gates I completed. Logic gates, I think all of you know how to do. Now this is half adder, full adder. Four experiments are over with this. Anybody has anything to ask, please ask. Any doubts? Or I will proceed to the next one. Just give me a prompt. Can I proceed? Any doubts you have, girls? Somebody can prompt me. I'll just give you some time. Just go through and let me know. Yeah, 110 also, it's glowing, no? The bulb is glowing. Any doubts? Saria, just find out. Mohita, Rebecca, Pavni, who are all there in my members, all 8 of you. Can I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So now let me show you something about flip-flops. One more thing you can do here is, you can just, before I go for the flip-flops, suppose you give A, comma B and Q. This is another interesting thing. I do not know what this circuit represents. So I write this as 0, this as 1, this as 1, this as 0. Generate circuit. Can you see? We've given a truth table. If you give a truth table, it's giving you a circuit. You see a circuit? This is nothing but, I don't know that you are able to see this. Can you see the circuit? So I have given A, B, and this should come down. A bar B, and this is A B bar. This is nothing but your exclusive OR gate. So if you want, A, this is it. B. Generate a circuit. See, the circuit is generated. And if you give whatever truth table you've given, 0, 0, it is 0. 0, 1. You can see it is 1. 1, 0. It is 1. 1, 1 is 0. So, what is it? As I told you, exclusive OR gate. If this is A, this is your A bar. This is B. So how do you write this as A bar B? For the first AND gate, it is A bar B. For the second AND gate, this line is coming from 1, so it is A. This line is coming from this, which is after the bubble. Sometime last class somebody asked me. This is after the bubble, so it's B bar. So this is A B bar. This is A bar B. So let me write here. Go to this, where should you go? Miscellaneous. Bring a text box here. You can bring a text box here. Inside this, you can write A. Let me put bar B. This is A bar B. Similarly, you can copy, maybe copy. Yeah, copy. And paste it here. This says A A B 1 A B bar plus A B bar plus A B bar B A bar B plus A B bar, sum of this is your Q. So this way also you can do this. You can construct any circuit like this and print the truth table. This way also you can do. Okay, let me give you one more combination analysis. Let's say A comma B. Let me give you Q. Next, this is 0. Let me give this as also 0. This also 0. This as 1. So generate a circuit. It has a generator. It has gone down, or maybe you say new circuit. Let me write AND gate. Now tools, combination. I think now you got this. A, comma B. You can write Q. Next, 0, 0. What did we say? AND gate. So this is 0, this is 1. This also is 1, this also is 1. Generate a circuit. See, the circuit is generated. The circuit is generated. 0, 0 is 0. 0, 1 also is 0. 1, 0 also is 0. 1, 0. OR gate, I think I have taken OR gate. So, 1, 1 is 1. So, rename this as OR gate. So depending on whichever gate, this is an OR gate. So save it as an OR gate. You can take it. Now this also you can have, actually I told you to print it truth table also you can keep A comma B and give this as Q. So that was, and we, what I wanted. So this is 0, this is 0, this is 1. Generate a circuit. This overwriting is not allowed, so take another circuit and do it. Okay. Fine. So this is how you can do. Let me show you flip-flops. Let me say R is flip-flop first. Basically, you can see these circuits in my dashboard here too. If I leave, I'll let it come back. You can just see, go to dashboard and you will be able to see my circuits as well. Maybe I'll link it in the new tab. Already I have constructed the circuit. So what is it that I am giving? 0. This is a D flip flop. Okay. I have given 0 here. This is 0. Now what is it that you are doing? This is after inversion is coming here. So if this is 0, then this is 1, this is 1, so this is going high. Let me make it as 1, 0, then this is high. So inversion, inverted output, this is SR flip-flop, if you remember, with an R gates is what you are doing. This is S input, this is R input, if you remember. So if this is 1, Q is 1, if this is 1, this is 0. So then if it is 0, this is a clock. Clock should be 1. If clock is 0, if this is 0 or 1, this is not going to affect. If only clock is high. If this is 1, this is 0. So this is S is 1. If this is 0, it will change. Can you see? If it is 1, if it is 1, this is a reset input. Therefore, Q bar is 1. If this is 0, this is a set input. This is set. This is coming from here. This is set. So NOR is actually complement of NAND. So this is how you are getting. Okay. So let me just go back. The new screen has to come. One second, I'm getting back my screen. Getting back my screen. So now you have seen, let me show you with the AND gate. Flip-flop, RS flip-flop with AND gate, NAND gates. So what you need first is inputs you require. So first input is essential. Bring the input. Two inputs are required. Two inputs. Then you need output. you need output LED. Digital LED, you take the digital LED here for Q and this is for Q bar. Okay. I'll show you how to connect the clock also now. Then you need NAND gates. Where will you get the gates from? Gates. What gate you need? NAND gate you need. Hold it here. It says it is NAND gate. Bring it here. Another NAND gate here. Draw these inputs. Draw these long wires so that you have to connect many things, so it will be easy and comfortable for you to draw. Okay, so this is your first input. This is your second input. Okay. And this is your, let us say, we'll join this and keep it. Let us see, later we will connect. Okay, so now this is a feedback connection from here to here. This is actually, if you leave it here, it becomes a open-ended wire. That is why sometimes you don't see the LED glowing. Connect it properly. Leave it here. This also I'm not very sure. It shows, see, if you connect here, if there is a mistake, it is showing here. So you should take the feedback properly. So you can see that it is not connected. Now it is connected. Looks like it's connected. Now this connection is made here. Similarly, you need see its connection not made here. Now the connection is made. So now what should you connect? This is one input. First input. This is the other input. Now connect, join them here. Join this without clock. Let us see how it works. Then I will show you with the clock. So now 0. This is 1. So this is S bar. Remember, this is S bar. S bar is 1. That means S is 0 and hence S is 0. 1 0. Let me make this as 0. This as 1. This is 0. S bar is 0. That means S is 1. Hence Q is 1. This is R bar. So now let us insert S bar. First R bar. S bar. Okay. S bar comma R bar. And here you write Q Q, there is no bar here, so maybe if you want, you can write S also, R bar, comma R, four inputs, so you can see the circuit as well as the truth table. Now S bar is 0, that means S is 1. He is taking it as 4, 3 different variables. See, this is the fun in this. If you take 3 variables, it is generating 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, like this it is generating. Okay. So let me, not this way. Let me take only 2 inputs. You can understand, I think. R bar, comma, S bar. This is Q, comma, Q bar. Okay. Next. So R bar, S bar 0. There is no change here. Whatever be the state, it remains in the same state. R bar is 1. That means R is 1. R is 1 means what? Q bar will be. Let me see. Let me show you what happens. This is S bar, R bar. Both are 0. When both are 0, what is happening? Q is becoming 1. Q bar is becoming 1. You can apply this and fill up the table. Next, R bar is 0. R, this is R bar. R bar is 0. S bar is 1. S bar is 1 means S bar is 1 means S is 0. Hence, Q is 0. Q bar is becoming, Q is becoming 0. Q bar begin. This is Q bar. Down one is Q bar. Upper one is Q. Next, R bar is 1. And this is 0. See what's happening? S bar is 0. S bar is 0 means what? S is 1. So, this is Q. Q became 1. We will write it as 1. And since R bar is 1, R is 0, Q bar is 0, so you will write this as 0. Okay. Each of these, you must take a truth table. Take each one of them as a separate screenshot. Each 4 possibilities. Finally, along with the truth table. Next, both are 1. When both are 1, what's happening? This is 1, this is 1. Both are 1. Both 1, 1 is same state. This is no change here. This is no change, whatever be the state. If this was a state earlier, it continues to be in the same state. Okay. 0, 0, what is happening? 0, 0, both are 1. This is forbidden. This is a forbidden state. You can write this as a forbidden state. So you can go to text. Miscellaneous. Or maybe you can take it, go to your word, type it there, and that also you can. If you want, you can write here also. Text. You can bring a text here and write forbidden. Okay, where will you write forbidden? Forbidden is this state. So you can put an arrow and show that this is the state that we are referring to. Which state are we referring to? This state. Something like that. Use your own creativity and try doing this. So this is how you will be discussing the different circuits. So now the same RS flip flop, if you connect an inverter, inverter means, where is inverter? Go to gates. Go to gates. Where is inverter? Yeah, this is an inverter. So how do you connect this? This. You connect it here. This end. This you remove now. This has to be removed. You remove this circuit. join this here. 0, it is becoming 1. If you give 1, automatically it will be going. So like this, you will be able to connect different circuits and then see what you can get. So till now we have done about one flip-flop. We will continue in the next class about the other ones. Any doubt?